So even with the deadline being tomorrow at 4 p.m. Eastern time, the Ravens were like, we don't need to wait until then. And they made the five roster moves to get it to 85 men. And they are as follows. It was announced earlier, so these two are no surprise. The Ravens waived Devontae Harris and outside linebacker Aaron Odoye. But the moves that they made after that ended up being Eli Wolf. Eli Wolf was also waived. And Eli Wolf, they signed him as an undrafted rookie free agent last year, I believe. And they had him on the practice squad. I think he made it through the entire year on a practice squad. But either way, he was in that competition for that possible third tight end spot. But now he's out of it. So both him and Jacob Breeland, they were both signed as undrafted rookie free agents last year. And now both of them are gone. So the other two moves that they made, they placed Eamon Marshall and Khalil Dorsey on injured reserve. Now, I was a little bit confused by the Eamon Marshall one because I believe that didn't he just like return to practice like last week? I remember they showed Biggie coming out and he was talking to somebody and whatnot. He had the pads on and all that. But now he's on injured reserve. So I'm not sure what happened. Maybe I missed something because I can miss some stuff sometimes. But so maybe I missed something. But you have to feel like this is it. You got to feel like this is it for the Ravens and Biggie. And it's like we've never even really got to see him play. Three straight years, injury reserve every year. And he never got to get out there. And I just, every time I think about him, the memory that we do have of him with the Ravens is when he got drafted. Because, again, they said that he was watching Avengers when he got drafted. But now this is the end game for him with the Ravens. I believe it is. Now, I know Jeff Zrebic, he talked about that they could possibly reach an injury settlement with him. Now, what they would do, what that would do if they did that, because him being on injury reserve, it ends his season with the Ravens. He is not going to play for the Ravens this year. But if the Ravens reach an injury settlement with him, that means he would be released from injury reserve and the Ravens would give him a nice little lump sum of money. And then he would be free to sign with another team. He'd be free. So if that happens with him, hey, hopefully it does. So he can get another shot somewhere. But if they don't do that, then he'll still have another chance with the Ravens. And with Eamon Marshall, and we talked about it this year too, I did not envision him making the roster. Our reason being because it was just, and it's a good problem to have for the Ravens. It's not a good problem to have for a lot of the cornerbacks who are on the lower end of the depth chart, but they have so much in the secondary. They got so much in the secondary. Like all the top guys, Humphrey, Peters, Jimmy Smith, Tavon Young. Like those are your four top guys. Now, with Jimmy Smith and Tavon Young, unfortunately, you have to keep extra because of those two, because of their history. So, Anthony Averett now, Chris Westry. So, we'll see what happens with those guys. But they have some good quality depth. Now, Sean Wade got added to the mix. Brandon Stevens. And that dude is going to be like a corner, safety, a little bit of everything. So, they have guys that can play the position. So with Eamon Marshall, it was just a tough uphill battle for him. Now, somebody else who was placed on injured reserve was Khalil Dorsey. And Khalil Dorsey, he came on with the Ravens last year because they were just them injuries. And then, of course, the COVID and all that, they just got hit. They got hit up like they usually do, especially at the corner position. But they got hit up last year. So he came on, he helped out for a bit, but now that's it. Now he's on injury reserve. So same rules apply to him that they do to Eamon Marshall. Now, they didn't draft Khalil Dorsey, but it's the same situation. Injury reserve ends their season. And just to give an explanation of this, because I know there have been a lot of people who have been really confused about injured reserve, the PUP list, and all that stuff, and when you can place somebody on injured reserve and when they can come back. Just to explain it so everybody's clear moving forward. Anybody placed on injured reserve before the 53-man roster is official. Anybody placed on injured reserve before then, season done. That's it. Their season is done with whatever team they're on. The only way that they could possibly play is if they came to an injury settlement agreement with their team. Like again, like we explained with Eamon Marshall. Ravens placed him on injury reserve. If another team wanted him, he would have to come to an injury settlement with the Ravens. Then he would be released from injury reserve, be a free agent. That other team could sign him. So, with anybody that gets placed on injury reserve right here, right now, they cannot come back to their team. They can't come back. The season with their team that they're on is done. It's finished. Now, for the injury reserve where you have a minimum of 3 weeks where you got to be out and then you can come back, that is for any players that make the initial 53-man roster. So, for instance, Rashad Bateman, we'll use him as an example because this is probably the most likely scenario. If it doesn't happen, I won't be mad because that could mean that he could come back before. But with Rashad Bateman, just as an example, Ravens are going to carry him into the season on the 53-man roster before week one. So he'll be on a 53-man roster. But then after the 53-man roster is official, they could place him on injured reserve. Since he will have made it through the 53-man roster and he then be placed on injured reserve after that, then he'll miss a minimum of 3 games. After he misses 3 games, if he's good to go, if he's healthy, he can come back. And that's it. Simple as that. And for injured reserve this year, there is no limit as to how many people you can bring back. It seemed like so long ago, but with the way that these NFL seasons have been, and especially with the whole pandemic, there's just been so many rule changes that have happened over the past couple of years. But a couple of years ago, you used to only be able to bring back one person from injured reserve. Before you couldn't bring back anybody. So this has been progress. Because before, when somebody got placed on injured reserve, that was it. Season was done. But then they changed it. They were like, if somebody gets placed on injured reserve, they can come back after, I think it was 8 weeks. And then they changed it again. They was like, okay, you can bring back 2 people on injured reserve. But still, they got to wait 8 weeks. So they got to be there on there at least 8 weeks, and then you can bring them back. So then with the COVID and everything, since that like threw a monkey wrench in NFL, period, it just messed up rosters, messed up teams. I mean, us Ravens fans, we know from firsthand experience because I remember that week, it was story after story after story after story. This player got it, that 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 player got it. And then stuff just kept getting pushed back, and I thought we were never going to play the Steelers. But we finally end up doing it on that Wednesday night. But anyway, the pandemic changed a lot of the rules with the injured reserve, but it did lighten it up. So now injured reserve, the minimum that somebody has to be on there is 3 weeks, and you can bring back as many players from injured reserve as you want to. So there is no more limit. And that has made things a lot better because teams used to have to make some tough decisions, real tough decisions. But they ain't got to really do that no more. So it's a lot easier to mess with it now, to mess with the system, so to speak. But this round of waves and this round of injured reserves wasn't very dramatic. Wasn't dramatic at all. Weren't any like surprises or anything. Devontae Harris, he was not somebody who I envisioned making the Ravens roster. Again, just simply because of everything that was in front of him. He had a lot in front of him. Eamon Marshall was the same way. Eli Wolf, I didn't think he was going to be that third tight end for the Ravens. So everything that they did today, it was not a shocker at all. Next week, they have to cut 5 more people or have to make 5 more roster moves. Not necessarily cut or waive, but they have to make 5 more roster moves. So next week, it could be a little anticlimactic as well. But the following week, like this week, you got to go from 90 to 85. Next week, you got to go from 85 to 80. But then the following week, you have to go from 80 to 53. Why they did it with the numbers like that makes no sense, but hey, it's NFL. A lot of things don't make sense with it. But that's where obviously all the craziness is going to begin. You'll see the stashes at that point. You'll see maybe any trades. We'll see, but I don't really anticipate any trades like that. But you never know with the Ravens. Because if Verdy keep kicking like he's been kicking, Ravens, they're gonna get something for him. They're going to get something for him. But anyway, team, keep it clean. Love y'all. Appreciate y'all. Thanks for listening. This week, just to give a little quick update for how this week is going to go, since we're going to be bringing back questions from subscribers, I know a lot of y'all have sent questions in from subscribers, so I got them. We will do them this week. Expect a lot of double uploads to where it's a video in the morning and a video in the evening as well. So turn your notifications on, keep your notifications on, because this week, I mean, just like every other week for a very long time for the foreseeable future, is going to be very, very busy. I appreciate you all supporting. I appreciate you all just rocking with the channel. I appreciate you all being patient, because I know y'all haven't seen your questions yet. So I haven't gotten anybody like, where's my question? Anything like that. So thank you for that. Thank you for being patient. So I appreciate y'all, team. Keep it clean. I love y'all, team. Keep it clean. Man, and just like these five players are, we out.